Hermit Crab.
Time to move, said Hermit Crab. One day in January,
I've grown too big for this little shell.
He had felt safe and snug in his shell, but now it was too snug. Hermit Crab stepped out of his shell and onto the floor of the ocean.
But it was frightening out in an open sea without a shell to hide in.
What if a big fish comes along and attacks me? I must find a new house soon.
Early in February, Hermit Crab found just the house he was looking for. It was a big shell and straw. He moved right in. He was waggling about inside to see how it felt.
This feels right, but it looks so, well, so plain.
In March, Hermit Crab met some sea anemones. They swayed gently back and forth in the water.
How beautiful you are.
The most beautiful thing you can wear is confidence.
Would one of you be willing to come and live on my house? It's so clean and needs you.
I'll come,
whispered a small sea anemone. Gently, the small anemone made a new home on Hermit Crab's shell.
In April, Hermit Crab passed a flock of starfish moving slowly along the seafloor.
How handsome you are.
Love yourself first, and everything else falls into line.
Would one of you be willing to decorate my house?
I would,
sang the little sea star. Carefully, the sea anemone helped the little sea star find its new home.
In May, Hermit Crab discovered some coral. They were hard and didn't move.
How pretty you are.
If you have good thoughts, they will shine out your face like sunbeams, and you will always look lovely.
Would one of you be willing to help make my house more beautiful?
I would, creaked a crusty coral. Gingerly, the coral nestled into his new home.
In June, Hermit Crab came to a group of snails crawling over a rock on the ocean floor. They grazed as they went, picking up algae and bits of debris and leaving a neat path behind them.
How tidy and hardworking you are.
Dream big, stay positive, work hard, and enjoy the journey.
Would you be willing to come and help clean my house?
I would.
Offered one of the snails. Happily, the snail crawled on the Hermit Crab's shell.
In July, Hermit Crab came upon several sea urchins. They had sharp and prickly needles.
How fierce you look.
Self-confidence is the best outfit. Lock it and own it.
Would one of you be willing to protect my house?
I would,
answered a spiky sea urchin. Gratefully, Hermit Crab picked it up with his claw and placed it near his shell.
In August, Hermit Crab and his friends wandered into a forest of seaweed.
It's so dark here. How dim it is.
Murmured the sea anemone.
How gloomy it is,
whispered the starfish.
How murky it is, complained the coral.
I can't see,
said the snail.
It's like nighttime,
cried the sea urchin.
In September, Hermit Crab spotted a school of lincolnfish darting through the dark water.
How bright you are.
Shine bright, be yourself.
Would one of you be willing to light up our house?
I would.
Replied one lincolnfish and swam over near the shell.
In October, Hermit Crab approached a pile of smooth pebbles.
How sturdy you are.
Coming together is a beginning. Keeping together is progress. Working together is success.
Would you mind if I rearranged you?
Not at all. Blessed are the flexible, for they shall not be bent out of shape, answered the pebbles.
Hermit Crab picked them up one by one with his claw and built a wall around his shell.
Now my house is perfect.
But in November, Hermit Crab felt that the shell seemed a bit too small. Little by little, over the year, Hermit Crab had grown. Soon he would have to find another, bigger home. But he had come to love his friends. The sea anemone, the starfish, the coral, the sea urchin, the snail.
a smaller hermit crab passed by.
I have outgrown my shell. Would you know a place for me?
I have outgrown my house too. I must move on. You are welcome to live here, but you must promise to be good to my friends.
I promise.
The following January, hermit crab stepped out and the little crab moved in.
Can stay in that little shell forever,
said hermit crab as he waved goodbye.
Bye, hermit crab.
The ocean floor looked wetter than he had remembered, but hermit crab wasn't afraid. Soon he spied the perfect house, a big empty shell. It looked, well, a little plain, but
sponges, barnacles, clownfish, sand dollars, electric eels. Oh, there are so many possibilities.